As you all are aware, pressure shipping is part of the dry bulk tramp freight market, and hence keep in mind that we don't carry any containers, nor do we carry any liquid cargoes. In the dry bulk sector, there are five size categories, and we are located primarily in the small handy size sector, but we now have currently in the water two ships in the Supramax sector. We also have a few ships on order in the Supramax sector in the future. This gives you a snapshot view of the company on different dates. And if you look at the most recent date as the 30th of April, then you can see that we currently have 30 ships. The average age has come down to 12.4 years. The insured value or market value is about $433 million, and the book value is about $394 million. So basically, book values and market values are coming closer together. The average size of the ship is now 28,700, and therefore we are more or less almost identical to the standard ship in the Baltic Handysize Index. This is a snapshot view of the Baltic Dry Index. It takes you all the way back to 1985 and brings you up to the current position. So you can see quite clearly that prior to 2002, the index fluctuated between a low of about 500 points and a high of about 2,500 points. Thereafter, the index has fluctuated as high and has gone up as high as 11,793 points, which was the all-time high on the 20th of May 2008, and then has come down to a low of 647 points, which is lower than the low reached during the Lehman Brothers crisis. If you look at the Baltic Dry Index in terms of averages, it gives you a better feeling. And you can see quite clearly how the cycle has gone up to a high in 2004 from a low in 2002, then has come down in 2005 and 6 by a smaller amount, and then has gone up to hit all-time highs in 2007 and 8. Thereafter, the index has been continuously falling. Now, if you look at the average for 2012 so far, it is about the lowest on record. The lowest average BDI was in 1986, when the index was below around 850 points as an average for the year. The years prior to 1986, that is 1985, and the immediate year following 1987, the index averaged around 940 to 950 points in those 2 years. So you can see that 2012 is shaping up to be one of the lowest years on record for the Baltic Dry Index. So obviously, this will result in a lot of stress for ship owners and their bankers. Now, this gives you a picture of what the dry bulk market looks like in terms of principal cargoes. If you were to look at iron ore, thermal coal, coking coal, grains, and other bulks, and this is exactly what it would look like. So if you were to then look at the percentage numbers for 2012, you can see that the market is roughly divided into one-third for iron ore, one-third for coal, and grain is 10%, with the balance being in the other bulks. So you can see that this market is fairly evenly spread amongst these three cargoes, and grain being the smaller segment in the as the fourth segment, fourth leg of the market. If you look at seasonality, you can see that pre-China coming into the market, the seasonality was generally low points in the middle of the year. And you can see this much better when you look at this graph where we have removed, or rather we have made the divided the thing into two time categories, that is prior to 2000 and post 2000. So if you look at the pink line, which is the post 2000, you can see clearly China's influence and the sharp fall that is there during Chinese New Year. You can also see the impact of the lack of grain movements in July, August and September. So this is still characterized, but if you look at the pre-1985 to the pre-2000, that is 1985 to 1999, the blue line, you can see clearly what a big impact the industrial production slowdown in the OECD countries had on the dry bulk markets. Coming to the supply side. Incidentally, this is the second ship delivered to us from ABG. If you look at the supply side, we are today, that is as of the end of the first quarter or the start of the second quarter, we have today more than 10,000 ships in the world fleet in the dry bulk sector. The average age has come down to a very young 12.28. This is the youngest that the world fleet has ever been. The average size per ship is now reached a Panamax level. And you can see that the small handy size, Handymax, and the Super Handymax together constitute more than a third of the market share. If you look at the lower portion of the slide, you can see how supply has changed in the first quarter, and you can see it individually by ships. You can see it in terms of numbers of ships changes as well as in deadweight ton terms. So you can see that on a deadweight ton term basis, the index, the supply side has increased by 2.43%, so which is a significant increase in the first quarter. So if you were to annualize this, you're looking at a 10% growth in supply. And you must keep in mind that in the first quarter, we've had the highest number of scrappings that have taken place in the dry bulk sector on record. So despite that, the growth has been extremely strong. Now if you look at the balanced growth that is there still to come, you can see that for the next three quarters of 2012, there's another 18.5% still to come. In 2013, there's 9.5% still to come. And then it sort of tails off. And if you look at this slide, we try to show you how two factors have been impacting the supply side. One is, of course, scrapping, and the other is slippage. So if you look at, say, for example, 2009, at the end of the year for 2009, the world fleet was at 479 million deadweight tons and had grown by 9.25%. This growth had come from the order book of 73.16 million, which was reduced by 41% or 29.36 million in terms of slippage, and further reduced by 3.3 million tons in terms of scrapping, to arrive at a net increase of 40.48 million tons or 9.28% as compared to the previous year's closing numbers. So if you come to 2012, what do we see? We see that the end year number could be as high as 686 million deadweight tons, which would come from the 141 million tons of ships that are on order, less a 30% slippage factor of 42 million tons, and less a 35 million ton scrapping year, making for a 63 million ton increase in supply. Now, this is what the first quarter shows, and we've simply looked at that and looked at those type of numbers and annualized them to come at this conclusion. Similarly, for 2013, the end year number would be 716 million tons.